Okay, hi my YouTube baby. So it's New Year's, and what I'm going to do is make some baked seafood. I'm boiling some potatoes and eggs. Potatoes for a hubby, and eggs for both of us. And I have some crab, lobster. Usually I do shrimp, sausage, all the extra stuff, corn. You could do that too. I'm just not in the mood for that. So right now I have some Kerry's Gold. I have half a big stick of Kerry's Gold, so it's about the equivalent to one usual stick of butter. And I have it on medium heat, melting down, and I am going to open up these lobsters and then make the sauce once this finishes. So stay tuned. Okay guys, so now my butter is done. I'm going to add a good amount of garlic. Onion powder. Old Bay. And this Old Bay is left over, so I mixed it with some nutritional yeast and some zatarans blackened seasoning that I had. So I kind of diluted it with that. Then I'm going to add some cayenne pepper because I like everything spicy. I just threw some fresh parsley straight from I'm literally just pulling it off of the bundle that I got. Fresh parsley. And I'm going to mix this up. Isn't it looking good already? This is about 8, if I'm correct, tablespoons of butter. So basically one stick of butter. Taste it. See if it needs more. I think it needs more flavor. I'm gonna add some more of this. Just finish out this my concoction. And add a little pink salt. And you may or may not use all of this, but I like to dip my crab in it as well, so that's why I got so much. Okay, and now we're gonna squeeze two fresh lemons. And if you want, you could add some heavy cream and make this a cream sauce. But you do want to be careful, like when you're tasting, grab from the bottom and then taste, because the places, the pieces on the top are definitely not going to have as much spice as the other places. Now your sauce is ready.
Okay, guys. So if you've never cooked with lobster before, usually just get some scissors and kind of in this area you want to pull down and make sure that you get the meat off of the shell. I don't know if you guys can see that, but my nail is in there, so there's meat separate from the shell. And from there, now grab your scissors and break the shell all the way down. Until you get to the bottom. And then now what you do is you do the same thing and get the meat. Get your finger to get the meat out of the shell. You see? See that it's all loose. Now what you do is you take from that bottom piece where the legs are, and you pull it up and out like you want to take it out of the shell all the way to the bottom, and then you put it back in, and there goes your lobster is ready to cook and season. I'm going to do this to the other three and then we get back. Okay, so now with one of those little barbecue brushes, I'm going to brush the sauce onto my lobster. I'm going to take the bottom out like we did the first time and get some of that good sauce and brush it. And put it back in the shell. Now get some for the top. So now I'm about to scoop this sauce and put it all over.
Okay, so now I have it on convection bake 375. If you're not doing convection baking, you're doing convection baking 400 is what you want to do. I only added the potatoes. I have the eggs sitting in some cold water, so I'll put them in afterwards. And then I have, for me, since it's keto, I have some kabocha, and it's a kabocha squash. It's like it tastes like a sweet potato to me. It looked like a pumpkin. It tastes like a sweet potato. But I'm going to roast some of this in my air fryer so that I can have that instead of potatoes. So hold on for that. I think I didn't get any of that. So I cut the kabocha into little fries. And now I put nutritional yeast, pink Himalayan salt, cayenne pepper, cinnamon, pink salt, and black pepper. And then I put a half tablespoon of ghee and a half tablespoon of avocado oil. And now I'm going to just mix it up. And then I'm going to put this in my air fryer on 400 for 15 minutes while my crab is in the oven for 15 minutes.
This is it. All done, guys. See, I put the kabocha in the corners.
And just FYI, because I only did 1/4 of the kabocha,
like, see how soft it is?
No, it's super. But because I only did 1/4 of the kabocha, it should only be 10 minutes in the air fryer. So that's the only thing. But everything else, I did 15 minutes in the oven. And this is it. If you missed this, let me know how you did. What you think. And enjoy. Soft.